Welcome to another episode of Coffee with Bart. This series on my channel started as a prank, as a gag, but it got out of hand because a lot of people are... Well, apparently there is a demand for me to do this, so I will continue to do so. But before we begin, I introduce you to the mystery bag. In here I have a surprise to reveal for you at the end of this video if you are interested in watching it. So what is this all about? I'm going to explain to you pretty soon. These things here on this plate are called bokkenpootjes. It's a Dutch cookie that you typically eat when you're having coffee or tea, during lunchtime or after dinner, for example. And they're called bokkenpootjes, which literally translates to goat's feet because, well, they have... The resemblance is there. I mean, use your imagination for a little bit. And you can see how they are named like this. Ladies and gentlemen, today I would like to introduce you to goat's feet. That's right, or in Dutch, bokkenpootjes. In case you're wondering what bokkenpootjes means, it literally translates to goat's feet. Let me open this up for a second. Aha, goat's feet exposed. Now, the reason they are named goat's feet is because they remind us of the feet of a goat, because there is this chocolate drip at each end of them. This is a very typical Dutch cookie slash snack that is commonly eaten when people are having coffee. Now, what are they? They are actually very soft kind of cookies with an almond meringue in the middle and white chocolate and dark chocolate. So the flavor is kind of like almonds, chocolate and cookie. And in case you're wondering, yes, Dutch people seem to like almonds a lot. Recently we had the gevulde koeken, the filled cookies, which also had almond paste in the middle. And these are no exception. So today I'm going to show you in this episode of Coffee with Bart the goat's feet, or bokkenpootjes, from the Netherlands. So, let's see what these things taste like. It's always funny if I try to explain to foreigners how Dutch stuff tastes, because sometimes I don't really have an appropriate comparison. Also, I have a limited vocabulary, because English is not my first language. So thinking of creative ways to describe a flavor is difficult. So let's have a bite. Looking good so far. It's a double-layered cookie, as you can see. So first of all, the almond taste is really overpowering. I'm getting a real strong almond flavor. And this is a common theme in a lot of Dutch snacks. We have something called spice, which is more or less an almond paste. We put it in a lot of cookies. If you watch all these episodes on my channel in which I show people Dutch snacks from the Netherlands, my country, you'll see that multiple of them already have stuff containing almonds in them. If you don't like almonds, you're probably missing out on a lot of Dutch food. I don't know why it is that we eat them so much. It's just that we tend to put them in almost everything. What's interesting is that they are really sweet, but I'm also getting this hint of bitterness. The texture is also really interesting. They're not really hard like you would expect from a cookie. They're not soft either. It's like this hardened foam, and when you bite into it, it just instantly crumbles. It feels like this hardened sugar, when you bite into it, it just melts. It's kind of funny. Interesting. Now, I have to say they are likable. They're not my favorite so far, because the taste is a bit simplistic. It's just a bit chocolate plus almond taste, which is pretty good, but nothing too special or over the top. But I think they're supposed to be like this humble snack that you're supposed to eat during lunch. Not something over the top. They're really crunchy. So, I have here a surprise for all of you. And at the end of the episode, I will reveal what it is. I hope you guys will get psyched, because I have something really interesting in here that you wouldn't expect. Yes, I'm teasing you. So, why am I doing this? Why am I making these kind of videos where I'm eating snacks on a channel that's about insects and nature? I know, if you're new here, let me explain. The rest of you probably already know, but just let me explain the concept in case new people are always watching, because this channel is always growing. I have a crowdfunding website, it's called Ko-Fi, and on this website you can give people a small tip, a financial donation. And the theme of the website is you can give somebody like the value of a coffee so they can buy themselves a coffee. Usually it's about $3 per donation. More is optional. So I thought it would be fun that if we reach a certain goal on this website, that I will actually drink coffee. And I will show you a unique Dutch snack from my own country. That's because the theme of the website is Ko-Fi, you buy somebody a coffee, so I'm like, let's literally have a coffee on YouTube. It's just a small reward, a small thank you for saying thanks to the people who helped me sponsor my channel, because this channel is demonetized. I gain nothing from doing this from YouTube. It's all the support I get from my viewers that allow me to have the free time to make videos. It's difficult, but I get a lot of support. But what's very funny is since I started doing this, for some reason, a lot of people like it. And now, in half a year time, this is already episode number 5. Fifth episode. And at first I was like, okay, maybe it's people who are just supporting me because they like my content, because they like my channel and they want to help out. But I'm getting actual suggestions for what to eat now on camera. That's pretty crazy. So I'm starting to think it's not just people who like my channel. I think that there are some people out there who genuinely like this series. Despite me being a YouTuber showing a lot of cool moths and a lot of cool insects, turns out I accidentally discovered that Dutch mukbang videos are in demand. And now I think about it, it is kind of unique. I live in a country where there's only 16-17 million people, the Netherlands. Not many people know about its culture or the things we eat in my country. So I was like, maybe I'm onto something, maybe it's worth something, you know. And that's why I'm here showing you this kind of stuff. Now usually in this kind of episode, I like to thank some of my contributors for the contributions they've made. But something interesting happened. This whole episode, like the whole video you see, it was sponsored by one person. So let me get to that right now. See, I usually have a $55 goal on Ko-Fi. And whenever we reach that $55 goal, I make the next episode of Coffee with Bart, in which every time I'm going to show you a new snack. But what's interesting is, instead of like 10, 20 people all contributing small amounts to reach the tips goal, it was one person giving us a large tip, which made us instantly reach the tips goal. So I'm going to read this one out loud, because this is pretty interesting. Ah, there we go. Let's read this. His name that he used is Aaron, aka Sir Real. I find your videos to be the absolute best content on YouTube, so I'm flabbergasted that your channel is demonetized, but I am eternally grateful for your devotion to insects and will gladly treat you to coffee for the rest of our lives. Long live Bart Butterflies. Well, thank you very much, Aaron, aka Surreal. This whole episode is thanks to you. There are no other contributors. It is solely you who basically kicked off this whole episode. That's pretty interesting. Cheers for sending me a very, very generous tip. $55 to a stranger on the internet. That's not nothing. And I will promise you that I'm going to do my best, my absolute best, to reward you with my best content. I'm working on a lot of stuff behind the scenes. The breeding season is really busy. I have so many mods right now, hoping to finish many mod cycles episodes this year. And I'm happy that you guys have my back, because indeed, these episodes are expensive and time consuming to make. So that's hard to do without crowdfunding. So thank you, Mr. Surreal. This one is to you. No. I was thinking, ladies and gentlemen, for some reason, this little prank of a series is getting a lot of feedback from my community. Which is strange, because look at the views that they get. They don't get much views, like 200, 300 views per upload. That's nothing for my channel. If I upload a good moth video or a good butterfly video, it's at least like 2,000-3,000 views in a month. These videos, they tend to hover around 200, 300 views. So I, when you look at views, I didn't expect people to like it. But it turns out that there is a small but very vocal, I guess, community. And I was like, damn, this is already episode number 5 of this series. What if we reach 10 episodes? Would that be possible? Well, we're already halfway there, are we not? And in fact, I already saw people tipping. We are already on the way to episode number 6 of this series. So I was like, damn, soon there will be episode number 6, maybe even 7. If we get to episode number 10, I'm going to do something special. And here I have it. See, in this bag, this is not a Dutch snack, but do you see this? These are fire noodles. As the name implies, they should be very, 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 very spicy, very hot. Now, I like spicy food. I have a tolerance to it. But I think if I eat these, I will certainly at least have tears in my eyes or struggle a little bit. And let's say that if we ever reach episode number 10 of this series, I'm going to eat these noodles. And if you like it, I will even live stream it. Although my webcam quality is low, so I'm kind of, I don't know if I would just make an episode like this using my camera to film, just a normal upload, or an actually fire noodle live stream. Let me know in the comments, what would you like to see? Personally, I think a live stream would be way more fun, because it's live. You can chat with people while doing it. It would be very fun. The only downside is the image quality would be pretty low, because my live stream, well, in fact, maybe I should get a cheap webcam with better quality video. It will cost me money, but then again, this series is helping me raise money. So maybe it's worth the investment. Let me know in the comments. Do you want normal upload or live stream? Good news is these noodles will not spoil. I'm pretty sure if I store them for at least a year, they will be perfectly edible, so we are not in a rush. I'm sure episode number 10 is going to happen sometime. And when it is, oh, I'm going to hurt myself a lot. So yeah. In case we have the next episode, what Dutch snack would you people like to see? Dutch people, please, give me a recommendation. Should we do hagelslag, tosties, Bitterballen, so many options. I prefer sweet things because they are more suitable with coffee. But who knows, maybe there's other stuff we can show off. Otherwise, I hope you guys are having a good time. Unfortunately, I am not. Not saying this to get sympathy, but lately I've been a little bit sad. I feel like I'm a little bit stuck in life. I know it sounds suddenly very depressing. Truth is, I'm not always doing that well. I look very cheerful on YouTube, but behind the scenes in real life, sometimes I have my own problems. Maybe if I feel comfortable talking about it, someday I will make a video about it. Or maybe not, who knows. There are struggles. But I'm not completely depressed. The insects make me happy. YouTube makes me happy. You guys make me happy. So there's like mixed feelings. There's a lot of sadness, but also a lot of happiness. Which are weird emotions to combine. But hey, who knows. Thank you for watching the goat feed. Yep, that's right. Bye bye.